Well, greetings, gamers. This is Dr. Ayleen, the gaming doc, and this is your place and your space to laugh, to chat, to chill, to hang out, to take a moment, to take a break, to take a breath and say it's Thursday. We are this close to Friday, but not so close that we don't realize that Thursday is valuable, because what is Thursday? Thursday is Think About It Thursday. Your life will follow your thoughts, so where are your thoughts taking you? And we have the first one out of the gate, our gold medalist, Iron Eagle, my Eagle of Iron, hashtag Doc's a Goomer. We're making it a thing. And my tea bag did not break in my tea, so I'm calling it a win. Anyway, Iron Eagle, hello, hello, hello. I know where my thoughts are going. Well, hopefully they're going someplace that is reasonably okay, and that allows you to see the potential of the amazing and awesome future that an amazing and awesome person like you not only deserves, but should have. And bang! Hello, hello, my dear. How are you all? I all are fine, and I hope you all, or y'all, are doing very well. I hope you're walking gently with the world, and the world is walking gently with you. How has your day been? Well, I mean, I'm not sure what time of day it is, but how has your morning, afternoon, evening, or night been? It is always so wonderful. Let's just say that someone will be kicked out, as I have been gathering evidence. Yes! Gathering of evidence, going through, creating the method, working within the legal framework. Smart. That is big brain. Because if you just go after the person, it's like they can turn it on you, but when you go within the system, when you make the system work for you, you got this. I'm Batman. It's 11 p.m. now. It's been a good day! Finally, a non-sober day. Well, you know what? Mazel tov. Happy for you. And I hope that you are, whatever it is, if it's a non-sober day, I hope it's a fun one that doesn't involve the authorities. So, yep, back in the 70s, it's like, it's not a good time if you remember it, and it's not a good time if you didn't need bail money. 4 days sober was more than enough. Let's do that never again. Oh, goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I just love your humor. That is so cool. And hey, go out and seize the day. Carpe diem. And yeah, sometimes, it's Miller time. And you just got to do what, life calls you to. So you go. So, it was an interesting day. I mean, I worked by myself as a chiropractor in a private practice. And so this whole concept of working with people again, it's a little bit weird. It's a little bit strange after 20 years of not only being on my own, but also basically being the boss. I mean, it was me. I had one employee, myself, and, but now it's like dealing with people and dynamics and others and other workers and other bosses and all this other stuff. And it's like, oh my God, is this what it used to be like? And I've been consulting my expert as I gather it. Good job. Good job bringing others into it. But as I said, we are very, very, very. You didn't give me my silver medal. Ba-ba-ba-bang. You are our definite silver medalist. We've got our Iron Eagle. First off, fist bump, high five for remembering and for letting me know. I'm old. I lose track of things. It's good you keep me up to date on this. See, it takes a village to watch a boomer wander around and ramble. So, no, it's not the Pyrex. This is an actual cup. This is an actual cup. See, no measuring marks. What have y'all got against my Pyrex? Technically, because it is a one cup measurement, Technically, is it not a cup? Technically? Samarella! And Ellie! Ellie, you are our bronze medalist! Yes, we have our first three in! We have Iron Eagle, my Eagle of Iron. We have Pa-pa-pa-bang! And we've got our amazing, wonderful Ellie coming in. Medalist, just like at the Olympics. Take your places on your risers. Wrap yourselves in your national flags as we play your national anthem. Congratulations, Ellie. You're an Olympic medalist. And I missed you too, sweetheart. So, yes, what should I do to get the gold medal? All you have to do is be the first one to sign into the stream. So whoever's first in chat gets the gold. But I know you can do it. But hey, you are a medalist. And it is... see, you thought that your day was going well, and then you can tell all the rest that you won an Olympic medal. Oh, goodness gracious, great balls of fire. You know, I'm learning to drive a bus, which is fun. If I wasn't so busy being harassed on WhatsApp, I would have surely gotten gold again. Is somebody disturbing your world on WhatsApp? I mean, if so, let me know, because I will unleash the fury of an entire horde of hobbits. We are really, really dangerous, you know, like at about knee level. But I will not tolerate anyone disrupting your universe. Let me at him. I'm fierce. And I mean, it's like, oh my God, WhatsApp, why? You know, and I'm very sorry. Nobody should be harassing you. You're an absolute delight. That's going to be a medal for Poopy Olympics, because I'm not that good anyway. How does it feel to drive a bus? Oh, the wheels on the bus do go round and round. It is a lot. Although I do have to admit, there's a sense of power about it. I mean, you cannot help but feel kind of powerful when you're in a 29,000-pound, 35-foot-long, 10-foot-high metal box. You feel powerful. Although, I do have to say, the horn does not have the gusto. It's kind of like, eh. I mean, you know, if you're on a bus, it should be Aruga! Ran around. Why that doesn't surprise me. Yes. And, you know, I may invest in a booster seat. I feel so small in it. I feel so very, very small. But, oh my God, there's a lot of parts to a bus that you have to remember. I mean, we have to know parts under the engine. I'm sure Doc will be exactly like Otto from The Simpsons. Oh my God, I hadn't even thought about that. Hey, dudes. We're riding the bus. Oh, I mean, I am going to have to go back and watch some of the episodes of The Simpsons. I can definitely see it. Oh, I've got to go back and study Otto. Oh my gosh, famous bus drivers. I will definitely go back and check out Otto. Thank you for reminding me of Otto. You know, it's, but it is, you know, I mean, I haven't hit the streets yet, so I'm not officially dangerous. But, you know, unfortunately, it's a very big parking lot. I'm surprised no one else has mentioned it before. Yes, can I harass them back for harassing you? Yes. See, pa-pa-pa-bang. You not only have me, the fiercest of hobbit warriors, you have an entire community, a tribe, a village behind you. And we will go, and Ellie will take them on for you. We will not tolerate nonsense towards members of our clan. You mess with us, you mess with the clan. Yes! We will be fierce warriors together! I don't know. Maybe I need to switch to decaffeinated tea. The tea is making me feisty. Or just the unbelievable power of managing a great big thing. I low-key like being harassed. Promise I won't make them cry. Oh, no, Ellie. No promises there. I low-key like being harassed. You know what? That takes an enlightened spirit to go, like, you know what? Bring it. Bring it. Oh, it is. Hey, we're almost to the weekend. Why not? Is a baddie. Yes. He's a rebel. Oh my god, you are such a rebel, pa-pa-pa-bang. Haha, I'll admit it. Yep. Sustained. Oh, but it is. Oh. I mean, it's almost the weekend. Oh my gosh. And. For anybody who is thinking about streaming, if you're thinking about doing a stream this weekend, make sure you let us know. We want to know what's going on. We want to know about all that. Just wondering, pa-pa-pa-bang, are you single? Pa-pa-pa-bang, you don't have to answer that unless you choose to. But it is... Yeah, it really is. As we head into the weekend and next week, at least here in the United States, next week, what is it? Monday is off because Tuesday is off because we're having Election Day. It is Election Day in the United States, and they've decided to make that a day off, like a holiday day, so people can be able to go to the polls and things like that. And because a lot of the polling places are in schools, that way the schools don't have to have students coming there that day. And then we've got Veterans Day that is going to be at the end of the week. Let's see, I am for now, but you are welcome to join the fight. Oh, I like that. Oh, wow, Dumbzara almost clicked on starting stream a few days ago. Really? Oh, Sarah's not dumb. Sarah's sweet. And who knows, maybe that is that inspiration to go ahead and stream. I mean, quite honestly, if a boomer who honestly believes that elves make her computer work can do this, you can do this. Let's see. That looks like you have someone on your mind, Ellie. November. Squishmons! First off, hey! November 11th is your birthday? Oh, happy pre-birthday! See, Squishmons, as far as I'm concerned, you get to claim the entire month. That's it. You get the entire freaking month to celebrate your birthday, to be honored, to be acknowledged. That is necessary. Yep, that's you. Shade for 20. Doc, OMG, hi. Hi. I just had to come in and tell you I had an interview today. Yep, you got hired on the spot. You start tomorrow? Double fist bump. Double high five. Yes. Happy clap.
It's all happy.
Congratulations! Being hired on the spot is an absolute win. What kind of tea are you drinking? Today's tea, the hot beverage of the day, is Mango Monsoon, which is from the Top of the Morning Coffee Company, which also makes tea. Top of the Morning, which was created by a YouTuber whose name is Sean, who is known as Jacksepticeye, and he created a coffee company, then he makes teas, and oh my gosh, okay. He doesn't know I'm alive, he doesn't know I exist, but I am telling you, I'm not sponsored, but I love this guy's teas. They are so amazing. There's Long Island Strawberry that tastes so much like strawberry. Monsoon Mango is like, oh my gosh, the mango flavor is so strong in it. And it is just, I mean, all of the teas are just absolutely, there's an Irish breakfast tea, and it is just awesome sauce. Raspberry lemonade. It is so good. So if anybody out there ever meets him, tell him that an old boomer lady says two thumbs up for his teas. I only know Long Island iced tea. Oh my gosh. I'll be working evenings at a hotel. You'll be at a hotel. Oh my God. That means you get like discounts on rooms and stuff. So if you ever need to like give yourself a little bit of a reward or something, usually you get to go and stay in like the nice rooms for almost nothing. Yay! And I think that's a wonderful job. It lets you meet people and, you know, and all of that stuff. And you'll be helping folks. That is so wonderful. And yes, oh my God, I would say I have memories of the level of poor choices you can make after having a Long Island iced tea. Because for those of you that don't know, a Long Island iced tea is a tremendously alcoholic drink that doesn't taste like alcohol. It tastes like iced tea. And I will tell you, bad choices can result when you are drinking something that you don't think is alcoholic. My new boss seems real nice. I got good vibes. Good vibes are important. I'm still a bit scared to be out of my house for long periods of time, but this is such a win. That is a huge win, and I mean to be hired day one interview, because see, what happens is, as soon as they met you, they decided, oh my God, we've got to hire her now, because if our competition hires her, we are screwed. If she's not working for us, she's working for somebody else, and that will only hurt our company. I'm telling you, that was the conversation that went on. They knew they had to hire you right away, because if their competition got to you, they'd be in a world of hurt. I want to have a job too, but I can't. Oh, my dear Ellie, it's just not yet. It's just not yet. You know, one day you might be able to have a job. That's okay. You know, and I'm sure that any company would be very happy and very proud and really benefit. They would do very well hiring somebody like you. See, if I had a company, I'd hire you, Ellie. So, you know, and for those of you who are out there and doing jobs and doing work, fist bump high five. If you're looking for work, if you're trying to, you know, create that new thing in your life, absolutely. Oh, and my attorney called today. The guy is taking a plea bargain to avoid prison time, but I can sue him for the mental and physical damage he caused me. Good. And I'm going to write up a victim impact statement to help my case. That is so powerful. I mean, it's not just powerful for the case, it's powerful for you. And I am so very proud of you, because through this whole thing, you did what a lot of people would not have been able to do. And you're so strong and so, so brave. Oh, see, that's me pinching your cheeks. That's me going, oh, you're so cool. Old people, we pinch cheeks. Let's see. He's being punished on the sexual offender list for life, yep, and a long probation period, yes, and a very difficult time, because he's got to report everywhere he goes. He's got to let people know about that. Wherever he lives, everybody in the neighborhood needs to know. And so there are definite consequences for that, including having a very hard time finding a job. So it's still good news, and he won't be able to come near me ever again. Good for you, sweetheart. Nope, Sam applied for a few, but they said they can't rely on someone with the disorder where they can't control their triggers. Put, not punished. Well, there is definitely, there's going to be punishment with that. Speaking of Kay, Sam's parents are out on bail. I don't know if that's allowed to be said here or if you're informed about it. I was not informed about it, Ellie. You know, and as long as you all are safe, and that, you know, they make sure that they can't come near you, and, you know, there are things that can be put into place to be protective of you. And, you know, and I wish you the best on that. I know that's kind of a tough thing for all of you. And you never know, because it may be that, you know, if Sam hasn't been able to find something, it just may be that that wasn't right, the right position for all of you. And I'm sure that there will be a place out there where Sam could be able to get a job that will understand and be compassionate. So we're going to hold that. I'm going to hold that good thought for you, my dear, and for the entire system. Please tell everybody I said hello. Anyway, Shade, that is amazing. You are just, oh my gosh, you know, you are the true the embodiment of the phrase, you know, tough times don't last, tough people do. And, you know, you are proving that. And I'm so proud of you for that. We still have a restraining order against them, so yeah, that's one good thing out of all. Hey, go for those good things, and that is a good thing. And, you know, the most important thing is that, you know, all of you can be safe, and that, you know, it you still are able to have those boundaries, which is really, really cool. You know, I mean, life just keeps going on and on. We're just trying to apply for a low-paid job like server or like fast food stuff. Work in a drive-thru and stuff. You know what? I think that would be very cool. Or maybe, and especially at this time of the year where a lot of places are looking for people who can help, like, through the Christmas time. I just had an idea. Christmas gift wrappers. Oh, I bet you guys would be so good at making boxes all pretty and sparkly and playing with tinsel and shiny ribbons and all that stuff. I think that would be awesome. And I mean, a lot of stores, you know, that offer gift wrapping, and, you know, they want people who can come in and be able to make things look pretty. And I'm sure you guys could make things look pretty. I think that would be awesome. You know, getting boxes and things. I did that. I worked for a retail store back in the early 80s. And, you know, at one point I had to do coverage in gift wrapping. That's not easy, and especially when you have to make it look like what's the box that's on the wall. Wait, did Sam tell you about the charity work? No, I did not hear about that. Inquiring minds want to know, what's the buzz? Tell me what's happening. So hopefully everybody has wonderful, amazing plans for the weekend. I mean, and remember, we are quickly running out of the year, which means that before you know it, we will be power sliding out of fall into winter. And for those of you who, you know, maybe you're living in some place where it's already getting the shivers, you know, that's something that you might want to keep in mind. You know, make hay while the sun shines before it gets all rainy and snowy. And, you know, I mean, and some people do like walking in rain and snow. I kind of like it. But, you know, while it's still kind of warm at certain points of the day, make sure you're getting out and doing those things that you'd like to. I mean, you know, have yourself a barbecue or you know, something. Do something that you can be able to, you know, to kind of enjoy that last bit of outside before we all start wanting to hibernate in our homes next to our heaters wearing our onesies. I've got to go by my storage unit and get my onesies. My onesies are in storage. I must go retrieve them. So, we are, like I said, you know, quickly running out of 2023. I can't tell all the details, but it's going to be Disney, Marvel, and DC-themed cosplay event in a local children's hospital. Oh my God, that's so cool. To support and raise funds for the families of kids battling cancer. Oh my God, that is such a cool thing to do. I mean, first off, it sounds tremendously fun. And second, what an excellent, excellent charity to be able to assist with. Oh my gosh, and everybody's gonna have such a good time. But that sounds like, and. Never think that might not be able to turn into a full-on job. Because there's always these organizations that are doing stuff like this now. And, you know, they need people to come in. And while a lot can be volunteers, sometimes a volunteer position can transition into a paid one. So the best work advice on finding a job, the best advice I ever got was figure out what you would do for free and then figure out a way to get paid for it. I mean, you never know. You might be able to get paid for something. Lukey! Howdy! Howdy, 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 howdy! How dub heck are you doing? It's so wonderful to see your name lighting up like that. How are you doing? What is up? What is happening? I hope you're walking gently with the world and the world is walking gently with you. And if it is not, tell it I'm watching it, because I will unleash fury unknown into the face hole of anyone messing with y'all. It's just Christmas, even through St. Jude. Yeah, you know, and St. Jude is such an amazing organization. It is absolutely, it is just so wonderful that parents of children with cancer have the ability to be supported and have their kids taken care of without creating a bill. And, you know, and that their kids get that care. So that is a wonderful cause to go with. I can't wait to hear about it. Oh. And then not even, oops. You know, it is cool. But, you know, and like I said, they have events year round. So, you know, that may be able to lead into a job. That would be very, very cool. So, you know, and for those who stream, remember, you know, the possibility of doing like donation streams and things like that. This is a lot of the times of year, a lot of streamers do charity streams. I may have to think of one. I'll have to figure one out. But yes, and you know, I think about it, it's like, oh my gosh, the weeks go by fast. This year has gone by fast. And being able to just go, all right, let's calm down. Let's just calm down. Let's let this year just kind of slowly ease its way out, because it has just been a heck of a year. I mean, is it just me, or does it seem like famous people are like literally dropping daily? I don't know what it is, but it just seems like all of a sudden every freaking day somebody famous is passing on, and I'm like, wait a dang minute. I mean, part of me goes, it's like, well, I'm glad I'm not famous yet, so. But, I mean, it just seems like, you know, we've lost a lot of stars, you know, actors, singers, you know, people in politics. I mean, it just seems like there's all kinds of folks just going. But, I mean, what can you do? You know, you put out a good thought. I wish blessings onto the families, you know, because even if it's somebody famous, you know, they had a family, and they have a family who's grieving them, and just because you may not have met someone doesn't mean you don't have a right to grieve. And that's an important piece. You know, just because somebody wasn't a personal acquaintance doesn't mean they didn't touch your life. And I remember when J.R.R. Tolkien passed away. I was 11 years old. I was 10 years old when I read the entire Lord of the Rings series, The Hobbit, Farmer Giles of Ham, and the Silmarillion. And I was just like, oh my gosh. I started reading Lord of the Rings, and it was like my fingers couldn't turn the pages fast enough. I was just, it was like living it in my mind. And I always wanted to go to England and shake his hand and say, I loved your book. And then when I was 11, I found out he passed away, and I was devastated. I grieved. I was so upset. Because, you know, it was like, but I wanted to meet him. And, you know, it's like, well, you know, I'll still catch up with him at some point. But, you know, it is really cool to be able to kind of, you know, have somebody in your life that makes such a difference, even if you never meet them in person. And, you know, it was weird, because I ended up as an adult, and it was after I went through a very serious health scare, I ended up sending a fan letter to someone who I really, it was a guy who was on a TV show. He was a part of a musical group. Okay, I will say Peter Tork of the Monkees. I sent a letter to Peter Tork of the Monkees. I sent the letter that I wanted to send when I was a child. And I did. I sent a letter and thanked him for, you know, the fact that as a child, he was one of my favorite, you know, TV characters, and I love how he played the part, and I wished him well. I mean, I never got an answer or anything, but then later on, and it was after Davy Jones passed away, and the other three members of the Monkees performed a concert, and see, on my bucket list was to see a Monkees concert, and we did. I went with a friend of mine, and so I got a chance to see the Monkees, and it was exciting, and I felt like a little girl again, seeing my favorite group, and they were singing all the old songs. So, yeah, you know, it's never too late to let somebody know that they made a difference to you. And even if it is a fan letter that maybe nobody ever sees, or, you know, just is like, oh yeah, whatever, another fan letter. Even if it's that, the fact that you put it out there, you know, letting people know when they make a difference in your life. Maybe it's a big difference, maybe it's a small difference. But we need to think about that. We need to think about letting someone know, you know, you made a difference in my life. So in that light, for all of you, you make a difference in my life. I had no idea I could feel as close to, care so much about, and be so inspired by folks who, for the most part, I've never met in person. But you're there. And, you know, for those of you who, for those of you who interact in the chat, and for those of you who, you know, kind of come in and just kind of hang out and maybe just listen, you make a difference in my life. You add to my life. And doggone it, I appreciate that. So thank you. Thank you very much for doing that for me. And I hope that, you know, my shenanigans and silliness and foolishness, at the very least, are, you know, reasonably entertaining. So, hopefully you guys are setting into motion all your wonderful plans for the weekend. And the main thing I hope you're thinking is, what can I do to treat myself this weekend? What can I do? You know, I'm getting my paycheck. It's like, you know, my first real paycheck. And so I'm thinking about getting myself, going to there's a local butcher shop. I think I'm going to go there, get a really nice steak, and cook myself a nice steak. I haven't done that in a dog's age. And it's like, you know, I've got some onions. I can get some onions. I can get some mushrooms. And, you know, because it's like, hey, okay, if you're going to have steak, you got to have mushrooms and grilled mushrooms and onions, or sauteed mushrooms and onions. And being able to just say, you know, it's like, you know what? I'm going to treat me. I'm going to do something cool for me. I'm going to get myself that little snack that I love. Or I think I'm going to go, you know, pick up that game that I've been wanting for a while. Or maybe you're going to treat yourself to a trip to a museum. Or maybe you're going to treat yourself to a trip to the beach, or, you know, maybe a trip to the forest. Whatever it is, that thing. Or maybe you're going to treat yourself to a day where you stay in your pajamas the entire day. All you do is sit, play some video games, you know, binge watch your favorite shows. Maybe you think about that. Think about how you can be nice to you this weekend. Think of, you know, and, you know, you've still got a day. You've still got Friday to kind of set things into motion. See, that's why you think it up on Thursday. So that way Friday, you can go, okay, here's what I need. You know, maybe you're going to binge watch your favorite movies, and you need popcorn. Never underestimate the power of popcorn to improve a viewing experience. That's why they serve it in theaters. So being able to say, you know what, I think I'm going to treat myself fill in the blank by doing whatever. Maybe taking, you know, maybe, well, actually, I've got a meeting I need to do on Saturday, and then I'm going to be streaming on Sunday. But, you know, maybe if the weather holds, I'll bundle up and go and take a trip on the Staten Island Ferry. I do so love the Staten Island Ferry. It's so fun. You know, you go across the river. It is very, very, very neat. And, you know, you just enjoy something. Find something that you enjoy. You know, maybe it's hanging out with your friends. Maybe it's being alone. You know, maybe it's gaming with a group, or maybe it's, you know, playing that one game all by yourself that you're still kind of learning how to play, but you're not quite there yet. As long as you're thinking about something that makes you happy, some way that you can, by the time you end the weekend, you'll go, well, I gotta get back to work tomorrow, but hey, I've got this memory of this wonderful thing that I did over the weekend. You know, maybe you got some pictures taken of it. Maybe you did a TikTok of it. Maybe you posted on your Instagram. Doc, I'm so mad right now. What happened? What? I mean, first off, not okay. Not okay at all. I'm telling you, I am just, everybody being picked on and irritated. The raging hobbit in me is flaring up. What? What happened, sweetie? Let us know how we can support you in this. I mean, it's just, don't people have something better to do than irritate nice people? I almost caught the guy I don't like doing a deal. Okay, if that implies what I think it implies, that should be cause for immediate removal. In the front room, the audacity. I mean, that is audacious. That is absolutely audacious. To do a deal, like I said, I'm kind of thinking along a particular line, but doing a deal in the front room, really? That's like begging to get caught. See, at that point, it just implies that this is someone who wants to get kicked out. You know, who is just like, okay, we're gonna set it into motion here. But that is so audacious. It's just like, why are you being that bold about it? Sometimes people are just wonder what the heck is going on there. You know, what is the thought process with that? So well, bless your heart for being vigilant. You know, rat them out. I mean, that's just wild. That is very wild. And, you know, I feel very fortunate to, you know, be in a place, and it's really interesting because we're a group of strangers. And everybody has their own room, and, you know, but we get together in the evenings, and sometimes, you know, we get together and we go into the kitchen and, you know, maybe we'll have a beer or some wine or some tea or coffee, and we'll sit there and we'll talk. And, you know, we've got one from Spain, one from Russia, one from, where is she from? Kazakhstan. Me from California, and then our host, who is from, you know, I think originally he was from Philadelphia, but now he's from New Jersey, or not New Jersey, Staten Island. I'm back. So I go downstairs to get a drink, and the door was shut, so I open it, and the guy he was talking to jumped up, and the subject changed really quickly. Okay, yeah, that's not a sign of something being guilty. That is so rude. You know, I think to myself, frick, frick, frick right now. I'm telling you, it's like, you know, but I mean, who has the audacity to do illegal stuff in the front room? That is that, you know, big brain, that is small brain. That is minuscule brain. I knew something was going down. Down seems to be where that was going. But, I'm telling you, it's like some of y'all live very interesting lives. So, you know, you just never know what's going to be going on with people. And, you know, and I guess that's part of the reason why I wanted to have a space where people could just kind of come in and talk about what they're dealing with and talk about, you know, what they're excited about and talk about, you know, current events in their lives and, you know, get support and get acknowledgement. My life be whack, but it is what it is. Well, you know what? Your life is not always going to be whack, because at some point, the universe will kick in and recognize how absolutely amazing you are and how absolutely cool you are. And all of this that's been going on is like the pressure that makes a diamond. And it's gonna, it's like, okay, we know Loki can take this. We know Loki can take this. We're turning Loki into an amazing diamond. Whenever I see Frost, I think of Jack Frost, which I did like that movie. The Guardians. Something the Guardians. Okay, now I've got to look it up. It wasn't Legend of the Guardians. What was that movie? Jack Frost. Okay, hold on. I got to Google this. Jack Frost movie. Guardian. Yeah, what was that movie? Rise of the Guardians. Yes, Rise of the Guardians. I loved that movie. Let's see. I got my name from combining Loki from Norse mythology and Jack Frost. Yes. Trying not to be mad at myself, but I couldn't just whip my phone and record it. Yeah, you know, I mean, you gotta still be safe because you don't know how people are gonna react. Oh my gosh, yes! Loki and Jack Frost, who are not entirely unconnected. You know, there is definitely the concept of mischief, of kind of, you know, that idea of creating chaos. And that was something that both of them were very good at. It was the idea that, you know, the storm and the snow that was disruptive and, you know, and the frost and all of that stuff that made everything slow down. But I see it. I can definitely see it for you. This is a very appropriate combination for you, which means that, you know, you have something amazing inside of you, you know. Fun fact, Jack Frost was originally Scandinavian. Yakul Frosty, which was an ice giant. I need to Google that. Hold on, I'm Googling it. Hold on. Let me get that. Okay. Okay. JAKULFROSTI. Hold on. We need. Oh my gosh. Oh wow. Okay. We are sharing this. Look at this. No. Go away. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Now that is a very cool image. I like that. Wait, let me bring me over here. There we go. That is such a cool image. Oh my gosh. Oh, Loki, that is, I love that. Wait, meaning he was a Jotheim frost giant? Oh my goodness, look at that! I love that. Jack Frost origins. ancient North mythology, Anglo-Saxon traditions, where he appeared as a mysterious spirit responsible for the icy beauty and bitter dangers of winter. Over time, variations of the Jack Frost legend evolved across European folklore before jumping to American shores and gaining a new life through 19th century poetry and stories. Jack Frost remains an enduring personification of the winter season, reminding us of both its perilous side and a role in reflecting our mortality. Let's see. It was associated with icy temperatures, nipping exposed extremities. Also brought scenes of spectacular frozen beauty and wonder. Oh my goodness. But that is so cool. That is very cool. Oh, see, I'm glad you shared that. Oh my God, I learned something new. I learned something amazingly new. Bladella, hi. Everybody, welcome to Bladella to the stream, who was probably last playing Fortnite a while ago because she's up to her eyeballs in amazing, you know, building a business and cookies. Michaela Lemon, very pretty, and Michaela is so sweet, and we are all jazzed when Michaela we get to meet. Yes. Hello, my dear. How are you? Jontun are giants, and they're, is it Jontunheim? Oh, goodness gracious. That's what I was trying to say. Oh, Michaela, are you tired? Are you a tired lemon? Oh, well, I hope if you're tired, it was from something that was very cool, like running a marathon or climbing a tree and saving a kitten or spelunking or Jotun, kinda. Thank you for clearing that up. My brother got a new dog at 7:30 a.m. yesterday morning and stayed up till 2 a.m. and my brother's already established the dog decided to bark at 8 a.m. this morning. Oh no. Oh, that is, yeah. Dogs can be loud. What kind of dog is it though? I'm huge order for my business. Will hopefully be here Saturday. Yes! I gotta go, waiting for my expert to call me. Let us know how it goes. My huge order for my business will hopefully be here for Saturday. Oh, that is so wonderful. Be here in a couple of days. But, oh, I was talking to somebody this morning about dogs, and they have a German Shepherd that is, like, immense. I am a fan of large dogs. Oh, they're both German Shepherds. Oh. German Shepherds are like really cool dogs, and when you've got a big dog like that, especially like a big working breed, man, you got to do a lot of walking. Oh my, I mean, my Sam was, well, even my dog Rocky was Australian Shepherd and part wolf, and my dog Sam was part Australian Shepherd and part Dingo, which is a breed called the Queensland Heeler. And he was a ginger Queensland Heeler. And so, you know, I've always had, like, large dogs. When I was a kid, we had boxers that, you know, got to be a pretty good size. So, you know, I mean, I don't resonate with small dogs real well. I mean, nothing against them, you know. The little purse dogs, for those who love them, much love. I just like something big and bulky, and the next dog I get is going to be a Rottweiler, and his name's going to be Carl. Let's see, the correct spelling is Jotun. Ooh, I'm learning things. Loki, thank you. The new one is a full breed. The other one is part German Shepherd. I've never had a small dog, but recently I want to get one. Look, Exiduck! You want to get a small dog? Which one do you want? Oh, for some reason, French Bulldog is coming out. You know, it's like I'm picturing you with a French Bulldog. We have our Christmas nails dropping tomorrow. Christmas! Oh my gosh, it's like, go into any store. I mean, it's like Thanksgiving is just an afterthought. Christmas is full on. I went to a local CVS, and sure enough, they've got the Christmas stuff out. But yes, 'tis the season to drive retail crazy. I've got a border collie mix, but I want just any small dog that's just like 10 pounds, even just a mutt. Oh, well, there's a lot of those that are out there. We just put up our two turkey inflatables. You've got turkey inflatables? I want to see pictures. Oh my God, a friend of mine, I could not believe he said this. He made the comment and he goes, well, you know what the best part about a chihuahua is? And I said, no, what? He said, you don't have to walk them. I said, what do you mean? He said, yeah, you don't have to take them out to pee. You just pick them up, hold them out the window, and squeeze. And I thought, oh my God, that is so wrong on so many levels, but I could not help but laugh about it. In show and tell, to the Discord. Show and tell. Oh my God, here are Bladella's Thanksgiving inflatables. Oh my God, they're so cute. They are so cute. I love them. I love them so much. And it's neat that you have a yard that you can do that with. Aiden! Aiden in the house. Aiden, how are you, my dear? What is up? They light up at night too. Oh, goodness gracious. That must be so fun. It's like around here, you know, everybody is already starting to pull down. It's like, okay, guys, it's only the second. Everybody's pulling down their Halloween stuff and people are starting on their Thanksgiving stuff. It's like, well, either that or, you know, some of them look like they may be skipping straight to Christmas. Because if you're going to do a ton of Christmas decorating, you may as well have it go 2 months. But, you know, but that is so cool. Steven must love them. Oh, my goodness. Our little guy must just have the best time. Steven has such an obsession with inflatables. Oh, I'll bet he does, but he is so adorable. Why not? You know, I'm sure he loves having something that's bigger than he is. Which, Jack Frost being a giant is funny because Loki is half giant, yes. Though the MCU has it wrong and they made Laffy a male ice giant when in Mythos, Laffy is an Aesir goddess. See, you can let me know if I'm pronouncing these totally horribly. So, I'm thinking that that's Laffy. And Aesir, the one on the left I just ordered yesterday. Nice! Hey, and Restream.io is telling me congratulations, you've received 100 messages today with Restream chat. Yay! But, you know, it is, I mean, I had like a real passion for, I think I was like maybe 12, you know, right after I got out of my Lord of the Rings phase, I went into a Norse phase, North and Greek mythology phase. Steven says hi, Doc. Hi, Steven! I hope you had fun on Halloween. Just don't eat all the candy at once. Yeah, hey. I mean, for anybody who ended up with leftover candy, fist bump, high five. Don't eat it all at once. Throw it into the freezer. Pace yourselves. The last 6 days has been so amazing. Today was amazing too. Yay! Since I was making the computer ready to be upgraded. But my mom and it made my amazing day turn into a day of despair. Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. Someone tried to scam her, so she deals with it by drinking. I feel so many negative things that I can't keep track of what I'm feeling. Oh, Aiden. Well, you know, I'm sorry. And that computer thing is amazing, the computer upgrade, and that is connecting you to a world outside of the one you're in. And I really hope your mom realizes she needs to make some changes. And my dear Aiden, at some point you will be heading out into your own life, and you get to leave all of that behind. And it's not that, you know, it's not about not being there for your mom or whatever, but she has her own path. And I hope that when your time comes, you know, you're ready, willing, and able to step into your own life, because you deserve to have your own life. You deserve to see what all the best is. You deserve to be able to have your own space where you come home and it's just yours. And it is quiet, and the only thing that fills it is what you want to be there. You've got that ahead of you, Aiden. You hang out for that. And it really is sad. You know, I'm sorry that, you know, your amazing time was made just a little bit less amazing. But when you get that computer going, when you get that upgrade done, and when you fire that sucker up and it just whirs to life, oh my gosh, I'll bet it's got lights in it. Aiden, I'll bet it's got lights in it. We have a grocery bag half full. Thanks, that means a lot. Hey, I'm an old lady who used to live in a cabin in the woods on a mountain surrounded by trees next to a river with a black cat. We know stuff. And what I know, Aiden, is you have an amazing life ahead of you. And it's going to be where you will look back sometimes. You know, these times in your life aren't even going to be your main memories, but those times that you think back to it, you're going to realize how far you've come and step out into your own world with your own space, your own life, your own path. And you're going to have that, Aiden. You know, you hang in for that. There's some good stuff waiting for you. And the best part is that you're going to make it happen. You're not going to sit back and wait for the world to give you things. You're going to go out and claim it. Yes! Fist my high five. You're going to be feisty out there. Yes, don't eat all the leftover candy all at once. You know, I mean, that was our thing. It's like we would put it in the freezer, like chocolate bars and things like that, and then they came out at Christmas. Loivy and Aesir and Loivy. Loki, thank you so much for that. I may have to copy that. I think I'll copy that. Hold on. Copy. I gotta put this somewhere. Either that or maybe I'll just take a picture of it. Hold on. Boomer doing technology. Hold on. Where's the camera? There's a camera. Okay, I'm gonna take a picture of that. Yes, I took a picture of it. I so love when I do. Old Norse is very difficult. I decided that I wanted to learn Irish Gaelic. That's a tough thing to learn when you're not there and when you don't know anybody who speaks it. So, you know, and the reason why I kind of wanted to learn that is because in Newfoundland, they speak a version of that. And I was born in Newfoundland, Canada. So I've always wanted to learn the language of my birthland. But see, Loki, it may be very difficult, but we've always got you who's going to make sure that we understand stuff. That is a good thing. I've also looked into Celtic mythos. Oh, well, as a druid, the Celts are near and dear to my heart. And in fact, I am about one-third Celtic. Doc needs to come home to... That's right. I need to go to Newfoundland because I still have to do the Newfoundland squash. And which means drinking moonshine, saying a poem in the language, and kissing a cod. Or screech. Okay. A Newfoundland screech. So, see, this is why I need help. See, what I want to do is I want to get my brother, because my brother and I are the last two out of my immediate family. and the two of us were born in Newfoundland. So I want to get him to go up, although he is not convinced about kissing a cod. I he said if that follows the moonshine, maybe he'll kiss a cod. My only response is, quite honestly, I have kissed worse. My favorite Celtic creature as of now is a brownie. Oh, well, for me, I would have to say a dryad. 13 years ago, I left my hometown, and I remember that I never felt so free. It made no sense that the days were mostly good because I was so used to it being so bad so often. But I got hurt out there in the real world. I got hurt real bad. So in the end, I came back to my hometown because the pain here is more bearable. I mean, you know, the pain you know is better than the pain you don't. Than the pain in other cities. I got my money stolen from me in the big city. No! I don't really want to go back to the wilderness city again. You know, well, there, my dear Aiden, there is a place for you. There is a community. There is an environment that's going to nurture you, that's going to, and you're going to find it, that is going to be that, you know, maybe not the big city, you know, something more gentle. I mean, you would have done amazing in the town I lived in on the mountain. You would have loved that. Everybody was just very gentle. Most people didn't lock their doors. It was, you know, it was a safe community on the mountain. If you needed something, people were there, but, you know, they left you alone. And I could so see you living in the cabin that I lived in. You know, just a little cabin built for one on the edge of a river that you could sit and listen to all night, and the deer would walk past, and you would walk in the morning through the woods eating wild blackberries that grew by the side of the path. See, that's the kind of place you could be. He'll drink enough to be fine with kissing a god. Like I said, I have kissed worse. Y'all don't need to know about that. That was in my much younger pre-doc days. There's a reason I'm old and wise now, is because I did a lot of dumb things when I was younger, but I learned from them. So, yeah. You know, and you know, I mean, there's always those infinite possibilities for things that could happen. And when I came to New York, I mean, I was told flat out I was going to go to New York. I was going to get probably mugged or assaulted as soon as I got here. I was told that I was, you know, that I was just, you know, begging for something bad to happen to me. I was even, I mean, these are people who supposedly cared about me. And they would say things like, oh, well, you know, you're driving across country by yourself. You're going to get mugged. You're going to get assaulted. You're going to get this. And I'm like, why are you wishing bad things on me? That's not what I want to hear. Was it possible? I mean, of course. But more than likely, It would go exactly the way it did go, where I had a lovely time driving across country by myself, and it gave me a lot of time to think. And sometimes we do have to kind of get out by ourselves to have a good think. You know, get away from the distractions. And, you know, and I drove for about 6 to 8 hours a day. But it really didn't seem like that. I mean, you know, I would drive for like, you know, 3-4 hours, then I'd stop off at a rest stop and get out and stretch my legs and, you know, take in the view of whatever state I was in and, you know, just think about the journey that I was making and how important it was. And yeah, I could have been mugged at any time. And I wasn't. And I was safe. And I reached New York, and I found a safe place here. And no matter what everybody else was trying to tell me about all the reasons why I should be afraid, you know, guess what? I was fine. I am fine. You know, I've taken the subway at midnight. You know, I've ridden the bus late at night and early in the morning. And again, could something happen? Yeah. Something could always happen. But something cool could always happen too. Yeah, I had my hermit one-year phase when I lived in a smaller city far away. My apartment looked like a movie set for a post-apocalyptic zombie movie, but I loved being alone. There is something to be said for that. I really needed that year to just not talk to anyone. I was at rock bottom, and I saved money by not eating, so I became super thin. In the end, it was not something I could financially keep up, so I asked my mom if I could move to her place, and she said okay. She was happy that I asked her and did that. Last time I lived with her was 9 years previous. Wow. So there's like this really whole major, you know, a history with you two. And, you know, I hope things work out. I hope that she decides that there's a better way. And, you know, you have your amazing life. And it's very kind of you to share that with her for now, even though it's very difficult. People confuse probability and possibility. Anything is possible, but most of it isn't probable. Loki, can you please put that in inspiring thoughts in the Discord? I love that. Probability and possibility. It's sort of like, you know, the idea that just because something, causation does not equal, correlation. Correlation does not equal causation. See, oh my God, I remembered it without Googling. Correlation is that, well, in many circumstances, if you have these particular things in place, this particular outcome happens. But it doesn't automatically mean that every time you have those same things in place, that the exact same thing will happen. So just because something is a part of a particular scenario doesn't mean it will always create it. And that is a, you know, I feel a bit better now. If I can have freedom like I once did, where I had so many good days, then I can have it again. Add that to the inspiring thoughts. I love that for you. And it's perfectly true. And that's a very powerful thing to be able to say, because there's a lot of people who would say, it's like, well, that train left the station. I can never have that again. The heck you can't. I mean, you know, the whole thing, if one door closes, another door opens. Well, if one door closes, try opening it again. It's a door. That's what they do. And maybe it won't open, but give it a try. Maybe you can tug that sucker open again. And, you know, and you will have that again, Ayleen. You will. And you deserve that. And, you know, once we set into our minds that there's something that really matters to us, something that we really want, I honestly feel that when we do the stuff we can control and what we need to do, I mean, even if it's just doing research on what's possible, that the universe will meet us halfway. I mean, we may not get exactly what we were looking for, but sometimes we get something even better than what we were thinking about because we hadn't even thought about it. So, you know, you've got this. I can't tell if I'm a young person that's wise or if I'm a young person with wisdom. If you're a young person that's wise, or if you're a young person with wisdom. Subtle distinction. I love subtle distinctions. And the idea that, I mean, and that's the thing, is you do not have to be old to be wise. Some people just have good common sense. And I think that common sense is a distinct aspect of wisdom. Because, you know, there's book knowledge, you know, there's that type of wisdom. And then there's just like, you know what? This makes no damn sense. That's a type of wisdom. That's that earthy wisdom. And Loki, I believe you carry both. You know, it's like, Mr. Harmless, hey! How are you doing, dear? What is up? I hope things are going okay. Things are going well. It's so wonderful to have you here. But, you know, it is. I mean, and sometimes I used to be of the distinct impression that wisdom was highly overrated. Because basically it's just like, well, yeah, you survived stuff. Because believe me, I know plenty of old people who are not wise. They have no common sense whatsoever. And it makes me go, really? Really? You're my age and you haven't figured some of this stuff out? My friend said they aren't doing good and their therapist made it worse. No. Oh, man. Time for a new therapist. That is... I am so sorry. And it really... You know, as someone who has assisted and, you know, with spiritual counseling, and basically, I just feel like I'm a really good listener. And sometimes when, you know, I'll throw something out, mostly to get somebody thinking, and they figure that stuff out. See, that's a part of that thing. Everyone has their answers inside of them. They just need the right questions to reach it. My answers work for me. They're the ones that I've had that relate to me. You each have your own answers, and they're very wise, and they're the perfect answer. You just have to believe that they're there and find the questions that will lead you to them. And I love helping people find questions. But, you know, I am a firm believer in therapy, in psychiatrists, psychologists, counselors. I think that there's a wonderful aspect to finding somebody who can be able to objectively kind of look at a situation and help somebody see it from another angle. And I have known therapists and psychiatrists and psychologists who are like, really? You'd really need to look into a different career choice because this is not it. This is not the one for you. I think one of the biggest issues is that sometimes therapists, psychiatrists, psychologists, counselors, they forget that that person has their own answer. They don't need to be given an answer. They don't need to have that pointed out. What they need to do is help people see a bigger picture so that they can find their own answers. And even if their answer isn't what the psychiatrist, psychologist, therapist, or counselor thinks is right for them, what that person thinks has nothing to do with that individual who has the right to choose their own path. Because that's what the whole thing is supposed to be about, helping people find their own path. I've been told I have a mature aspect at conflict because I've been able to disassociate from my emotions while solving problems. Excellent quality. Man, I think that is a very, very cool quality. And it's something that a lot of people don't have a knack of because they get wrapped up in the feels. And in fact, I knew of one therapist who seriously needed a therapist. She was kind, you know, and she ended up having some very unusual circumstances in her life. And rather than seek out help, she kept it's like, well, I'm a therapist, you know, I know what I'm doing. It's like, no, you don't. No, you don't. You need somebody else to talk to. And yeah. So sometimes there's like almost a transference thing where the therapist like sees themselves or a part of themselves in the person they're supposed to be helping, and they lose their objectivity. You know, something kind of triggers in them about the situation that somebody else is going through. And then they go out of the place of like a witness to, well, no, I have to fix this because if I fix you in the way I want, then that part of me that was damaged will be fixed. So that is a tricky thing. And Mr. Harmless, I hope your friend is okay. I hope your friend, you know, and your friend is very brave to be going and speaking to somebody, and I'm very proud of them. And I hope that, you know, they'll be able to be all right after this, because that can be a bit of a thing. Today I have decompressed my anger feeling, then I showed compassion to myself. Good for you. And have my inner self say, it's tough for you. I understand. I love you, and it's very unfortunate that you have to go through this. And then I send my inner self to the basement cell again because I don't like that inner version of myself. Ah. And then I express my thoughts out loud, and now I feel better, in contrast to before. You know what? I am so happy for you. Oh my gosh, you're so smart. That is a very cool way to do it. I like that. I mean, if you don't mind, could you put that in inspiring thoughts? Because I think that is very inspiring. I never heard so much pain and depression in someone's voice until Halloween night. Really? Oh, poor baby. Before, my whole day or several days were ruined, and I kept on feeling the feelings and letting it consume me over days and days. I come to a monster that I don't recognize. All right, I become a monster that I don't recognize. Snoring Bush, my god of ghillie suits. Good to see you again, Doc. How are you? I am doing awesome and even a little bit better now that your bushy little self is here.
It really is that feeling of when we don't feel we have choice, when we don't feel empowered, and we just get kind of pulled into the current. And often it's the idea of that anger coming up because in anger we feel strong. We have that belief that, I mean, there's adrenaline, there's a lot of biochemical reactions, but even emotionally, it's like anger makes us feel powerful. So, you know, and whenever I get really angry about something, I will stop and ask myself, what am I afraid of? Because for me, in my case, I know that pretty much in almost every case where I really got angry at someone, when I thought about it, there was something I was afraid of. And maybe I was afraid of being hurt again. Maybe I was afraid of being left alone. Maybe I was afraid of not being good enough. And, you know, it's like when my marriage ended. You know, my husband decided to be with someone else after 20 years of us together. And I got very angry. And it took a while for me to kind of peel back the layers, but I was scared. I was afraid that meant I wasn't good enough, that I wasn't worth it, that if I was such a great person, why was it easy to leave me? And it took me a while to figure out that it wasn't easy to leave me. It was just what he felt he had to do because I had changed. You know, I had grown. But yeah, I took it that it was a sign that even after 20 years, I wasn't worth holding on to. I wasn't the first choice. And once I realized that it was just me being scared, I found that the anger went down because I didn't worry about dealing with my anger, I dealt with my fear. And once I dealt with the fear, the anger kind of went down on its own. We finally got a creep kicked out of our group. Yes, good. Yes, it is many years. We were met, in fact, he told me that he wanted to leave, 2 weeks before our 20th wedding anniversary. And we had known each other since I was in kindergarten and he was in first grade. We lived a house down from each other. So, yeah, that was a shock. And as shocking as it was, as painful as it was, I can quite honestly say that I wouldn't be here if I hadn't chosen to walk away and let it go. If I had chosen to stay in the marriage, no matter what, no matter how miserable it made us, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't have gone to Africa. I wouldn't have gone to England. I wouldn't have gone to Central America. I wouldn't have gone to Brazil. I would not be in New York now. I wouldn't have been on a Broadway stage. Well, technically off-Broadway. So I think that that was what we needed to do. I believe that, you know, we have spiritual contracts with the people in our lives. And every single contract that has ever been made has a point where it is complete. And my feeling was our spiritual contract became complete. And it allowed us to, he was able to be with someone that could keep him feeling safe, and I was able to grow. So it worked out well. He made a 12-year cry because of how uncomfortable he made her. Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, that's heartbreaking. And every blessing to your friend. And, you know, sending out just absolute love for her. And speaking of marriage, I'm finally finding closure. Oh, Snoring Bush. After looking at and reading it many times, something just clicked in my thought process, and it seemed to fade. Oh. Fist bump, high five. I am so proud of you. Ooh, pinching your cheeks, pinching your cheeks, pinching your cheeks. I'm old. We do that. But that is, I am so proud of you, sweetie, quite honestly. I know that that was like a, just a really epic journey, and I am so happy for you. And all the things that open up. And it's not that it's never going to be there again. It's just you created the opportunity to shift it and evolve. Wow, you've been in so many places. Oh, I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere. Johnny Cash, amazing musician, amazing singer. That was very relatable because just recently, like within the past 2 months, I both got dumped and most of my friends decided to completely stop talking to me. Yep. We didn't lie to get him. We found enough evidence so the heads could kick him out fairly. Exactly. Work with it. We were talking about Iron Eagle about that. You work within the system. You make that system work for you. That's how you get things done. But, you know, I'm very proud of you for, you know, making sure you guys did the thing right that gives you the outcome that you really want. Yes! You guys rock. You guys absolutely rock. You guys are so impressive. Oh, my God. I am just honored to be in the presence of all of you. Yeah, it, and, you know, and sometimes it is about figuring out the way to get to the thing, to get to where you want to be. And first, we have to really be committed that that's where we want to be. There's a lot of people who, you know, it's funny because they'll choose to do, like, you know, back when I was a doctor, and I would have patients who would say, well, I want to be in great shape, and I want to do this, and I want to run a marathon. And I thought, that is so wonderful. Okay, here's the things you need to do. Here's the stuff that can get you there. And they didn't want to do any of it. Oh, they talked about wanting to do things, but it's like, okay, well, if you want to be able to do this, then we're going to need to increase your stamina a little bit. So I want you to start off, you know, by just, you know, taking little walks each day, even if it's just down to the end of the block and back, or, you know, if whatever. And, you know, you can increase your water, and, you know, let's work on, you know, maybe getting you to a healthier body size. And they didn't want to do any of, oh, well, that seems hard. You know, and then it's like, but you want to run a marathon. In order to do that, you need to be able to, you know, you need to be able to at least get to the end of your driveway and back. You know, you need to work on these things. But no, they just kept talking about wanting to be in a marathon, but they were never willing to do anything in order to make it happen. They had every excuse. Oh, well, you know, I was too tired this week to get up and walk. It's like, well, you know, so when they would tell me, it's like, oh, I want to run a marathon one day. It's like, well, good luck with that. You know. Well, I realized I had healed more than I thought I had when a friend of mine offered to set me up on a date. I told him I'm actually happy being alone right now. instead of taking him up on the offer. Normally I'd be happy to, but I feel happy and feel as though having someone might actually mess that up. Snoring bush fist bump high five. I understand. But that's very cool. That is awesome. And that is an evolution. She, which is he, I forgot he's trans. He was holding on to me and wouldn't let go of me. He's my friend now. It's a bit weird because I'm 19 and they're 12. I'm scared that someone will say I did something to him when I haven't done anything. You know, I mean, it is. And there are ways to manage that and, you know, have that be like a sibling type of thing. But, you know, as long as you're aware that misunderstandings can happen, you know, I mean, the best way to get out of a trap is to not get caught in it in the first place. And the best way to not get caught in it in the first place is to know that it exists. So by knowing that, you know, some might misunderstand it, that you make sure that it's like, oh, okay, well, you know, we hold this in a different way. And you should be able to be just fine. My day was amazing today. Yes, because the woman at the post office was very charming. Oh, nice. She gave me my computer parts that I needed. I accidentally touched her hand when I gave her my ID card. She gave me butterflies. Oh, and I never feel butterflies like ever. She talked and looked at me the way not many do. Now that my mental health is getting better, I feel like I can connect with people finally. Ayleen, that is so fun. That is so cool. That is so wonderful. Pinching your cheeks. Pinching. This has been a pinching your cheeks type of stream. One of my friends back is truck up into a dumpster. Oh, backed his. I said, I would guess one of my friends backed his truck up into a dumpster. That's not a good place for a truck. And as somebody who's learning to drive a bus, I totally get that that can be tricky trying to back one up. I look at my schedule and all the things I get to do. I love how you say get to do, not have to do, get to do. I really enjoy 99% of my schedule. Having someone might interrupt my schedule. Like when I go to the BJJ gym, I only get to go on Wednesday. What if they want to hang out at that time on Wednesday? No, thanks. I mean, quite honestly, there is an aspect of that. It's like, okay, I've got a really cool life right now. And, you know, it's like, I don't need something extra that I have to pay attention to. I like not having anything extra I have to pay attention to. Does that mean I'm never going to have another relationship of the romantic kind? I mean, maybe. I think I will. I think I could. And if I end up being romantically involved with someone again, yeah, first off, he better know how to cook. But, you know, and second, he's got to like video games. So being able to work that in, but I'm also a firm believer that when the right time comes, when the right time happens, I'd be open to that. I know that I would be open to that. But for now, I don't really need that. You know, I'm not afraid to be alone. And once you start getting into your 60s, people are very afraid of being alone. There's this whole thing of like, I don't want to die alone. It's like everybody dies alone. I mean, unless you're on like a plane or something. But, you know, okay. But yes, maybe he'll have a Rottweiler named Carl. See, I will take that as a sign if I meet somebody and they've got a Rottweiler named Carl. I'm actually trying to lose weight right now. 175.8, want to be around 150. Actually going to the gym. Loki, good for you. I mean, you know, okay, at my peak, at my heaviest, you know, full disclosure, I was at about 215 and I'm only 5 feet tall. So basically, I looked like something that an Oompa Loompa has to roll out of the room because they ate the bad gum. Oh my gosh, I was literally as big around as I was tall. I was almost a perfect circle. And I'm still working on that because I can have an unhealthy relationship with food, and I'm an absolute stress eater, and I work really hard to have a better relationship that I can eat because I enjoy it, not because I need it to make me feel better. So it's a tricky thing, but I love that you're going to the gym. That is very cool, Loki. My own sister called me a what? You're trying to make him feel safe because he felt unsafe around the creep. Yeah, I think your sister needs to, like, touch some grass, hug a tree, and get a Snickers bar. I think that that's, no. There are gyms that have the BJJ sessions and wrestling during the morning before workout. A lot of middle-aged dads wrestle a lot before work in the morning. Oh, first rule of Fight Club. They're all Fight Club guys, aren't they? I don't like waking up early, though, but it's cool that there are gyms like that. You know, at Snoring Bush, yeah. You know, well, I just have to be honest with people. Can you bring me more happiness than what I'm doing on my own? Can you bring me more happiness than what I'm doing on my own? Probably not. Nothing against them, but it's just how I feel about it. Snoring Bush, please put that in inspiring thoughts. I think that that is something people really need to think about. That, you know, because people get so intent on wanting a relationship. If you're that intent on wanting a relationship, then any relationship will do, even an unhealthy one. And there are a lot of people in very unhealthy relationships. And, I mean, really, if you are doing well, and yeah, you know, and maybe the answer to that question is yes. And if the answer to that question is yes, full speed ahead. But the idea of, you know, because, you know, when you take somebody on, you take on both their light and their shadow. But I really like that, Snoring Bush. I really do. I go to a Gracie Academy right now. Absolutely love it. Ooh. Sorry, burps. A great instructor's fun community that I call a family. I recommend it. Yes. Ah, Sicario. Hi. Hi. Welcome. It's so wonderful to have you here. I'm very happy to meet you or see you. And if we've met before, I don't mean to forget. It's just that there's a lot of people who comes in and I'm old. But it's such a delight. If you are a streamer, please feel free to talk about your stream in the chat. We'd love to know more about it. And you being one of our kick friends. Yay! It's so nice to have you here. I hope you're walking gently with the world and the world is walking gently with you. I personally like being cut because I enjoy dressing up. I look good. I know you will. Hey, I'm almost a middle-aged dad. Almost. Hey, middle age is a very interesting age. Nice. I don't know if Gracie Academies exist here. Ah. Da-da-da-da. We don't talk about Fight Club. My dog had surgery. Oh, I can't remember if I told you, but she was hit by a car. Yes, you mentioned that. How is she doing? Fractured many bones, broke her back leg in 4 parts. 2 parts were small. Oh, how is she doing? Oh, sending out many good thoughts for puppers. I hope she's okay. Definitely keep us posted. If you have any pictures, please post them over in the animal section. For me, eating was never a problem. In fact, I feel that eating is an obstacle that is stopping me from playing video games to unhealthy cope with my problems. But I have healthy coping mechanisms now instead. Good for you. You turned 28 in four days? Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Oh, the Snoring Bush birthday on the 6th. Happy pre-birthday, my dear. So many times I choose to not eat so I can play video games instead and forget about my problems. You know, when I was going through that, like, really difficult thing and where, I mean, basically, it had nothing to do with hunger. People would say, it's like, well, take an appetite suppressant. I said, I don't have an appetite. I just eat. It doesn't matter if I'm hungry. It doesn't matter if I'm full. I'm going to eat. So, yeah, you know, being... in fact, video games are one of the things I turn to avoid eating. So, I get it. And in reality, middle age is really like 35 in terms of lifespan. Well, lifespans are growing more. So, middle age, technically, since a lot of people are living into, you know, three-digit numbers. But yes, either way, I'm on the far end of it. I'm on the other side of middle age. I'm in the where the hell are my glasses and, you know, that sort of thing. And oh, what a life I have lived these 28 years. That's right. 28 years is just a number, but when you have filled that number with all awesomeness, it's like, you know, the saying, life is a tiny dash between two dates on a headstone, and neither one of those dates matter as much as how much you can fit in that little dash. And snoring bush, you have shoved a boatload in there. You've got the Hermione's bag of little dashes. She's okay. Oh, I'm so glad. I do. Give me a minute. Yes. And Terminator Lips 90, hello there. Well, hello there, General Grievous. How are you? It is so wonderful to meet you. It's such a delight to have you here. And I hope you're doing well. And I hope that if you're a streamer, you let us know. I mean, I know normally talking about your stream in other people's chats is a huge no-no. But here, not only is it okay, it's encouraged. Because if you stream, you should be proud of yourself. Because you're not doing something that's easy. And also, if you stream, you should be letting people know about it. Because, I mean, some people just have an account just for kicks and giggles. And other people want to build it into something. And if you're somebody who wants to build your stream, networking is necessary. Which is why I want people to be able to talk about their streams so they can have a place to network. Because the world deserves to hear and experience what you have to offer. Lifespan has been going up until COVID. Now it's falling again. Check Discord. I will. Bang! I miss everything because I'm being harassed so bad. No! I never feel hungry. I just eat my three meals because that's what I'm supposed to do. You know, it was funny because my niece married a young man from Ghana, and he's Muslim. And so that he doesn't feel lonely celebrating Ramadan because no one else in the house is Muslim, then I would celebrate Ramadan with him. So that meant that during between sunrise and sunset, I couldn't eat. And it was the weirdest thing because... You know, it was like, wait a minute, it's afternoon, it's lunchtime. And I realized I wasn't eating because I was necessarily hungry, but I was eating because, well, this is the time that you eat. So, it is, oh, goodness. Okay, so, we've got pictures here of a puppers who has had surgery. So, you know, this may be a little bit, you know... So what we will do, let's see. We'll look at the x-ray. We'll look at the x-ray. The other one is like the incision, but I don't want anybody to feel, you know, to feel uncomfortable because it might be a little bit upsetting. So we're going to focus on the x-ray. And as a doctor, that is one heck of a fracture. That is, you know, when you're dealing with a fracture like this, you know, but, you know, while it's not entirely clean, it's clean enough to be able to work with, that they can realign that. So, yeah, but, you know, this is one lucky puppers. That is a very lucky puppers. And she's so lucky to have you. You know, and I'm glad that, you know, she's going to be okay. Yeah, that is nasty. That is a nasty fracture. So if you want to see the incision, you can go to Discord and see that. You know, it's just that I felt that it was best not to share it, like, you know, out in the open, because for some people it might be a little bit upsetting, but you know, it is. Let's see. You say you're doing something that's not easy. What would you consider easy? Honest question. Honest answer. I would say what I would consider easy is something that, let's see, how would I define easy? Something that requires only a minimal amount of my energy. Something that does not evoke a huge emotional reaction. It's something I don't have to feel I have to work to overcome, which in most cases are the things that I'm probably not going to learn as much from, because we really don't learn as much from the easy stuff as we do from the more challenging things. But I think we all, it's sort of like you go to a movie that isn't about making you think, that isn't about evoking a powerful emotion. It's just a goofy movie. It's a goofy, silly movie that is simply there to make you laugh. To me, that's easy. But if I watch a movie that just like grabs me by the heart and shakes me, or that makes me want to think about it and talk about it and, you know, and figure stuff out and debate it, you know, that's not that easy. So I suppose, yeah, if it does not evoke a significant amount of emotion in me and it does not require a significant amount of energy from me, I'd say that would be my definition of easy. I've done very few things in my 18 years of life, but I hope I changed people's life for the better in my short time. Loki, my dear, you've changed mine for the better just by being you, by showing up and sharing the things you do and sharing, you know, the information you have. I now have a cool image of Jack Frost saved in my computer. So yes, I would say that just by coming into the stream, you change people's lives for the better. So, accomplished. Poor doggy, yeah. She has a rod, yeah. Makes me think about my first cat, yeah. OnlyFans and stuff like that is something I'd consider easy. Going where the fence is lowest. Yeah, I mean, I guess it depends on what you do. And, you know, I mean, yeah, I mean, OnlyFans, kind of, there's a certain inclination about that. And I think that, you know, maybe it's easy to do, but is it truly easy on the person? I mean, and that's a question only that person could answer. Maybe it is easy on them. Maybe they really don't, you know, like, hey, this is me. You know, or maybe if there is like, well, I need to make money and I'm doing this, I'm not totally keen on it. But so I think that it has a lot to do with the perspective of the person experiencing it. First it was my dog, then it was the creep, then it was the thing my friend had to go through this 1 week. Yeah, that was a lot. Good answer. Thank you. I occasionally have those when I'm not losing my glasses. Well, when it comes to getting experience between those two dashes, I hate the idea of a 9-to-5 job in a small town surrounded by the same faces. Oh my God. Okay. Let me finish reading it, and then an image came immediately to my mind, Snoring Bush. I'd rather live a life or adventure, even if that adventure is scary sometimes. Good for you. Put me in the best or worst places in the world, and I'll be happier than someone in a cubicle and grow into someone my kids can look up to. They don't need Superman if I work hard enough. Nice. Okay. Right when you said talking about like the 9-to-5 job, I immediately got this vision of you in a full-on ghillie suit in a cubicle with a name badge. It's almost like Cousin It. Any of you who remember, okay, people who do not remember the Addams Family. Hold on. Cousin It, Addams Family. Images. Okay, this was Cousin It. Oh, gotta move me. Okay, this was Cousin It. And Cousin It was in the old TV series, The Addams Family. And I'm sorry, I just pictured you kind of looking in a ghillie suit that would look like this, sitting in a cubicle, and people walking by going, it's like, hey, how's it going? And they're just like in their little zone, and you're sitting there in the ghillie suit. I'm sorry, I my brain went there. Cousin It was amazing. I loved Cousin It. He was so cool. But yes, that is where my brain went. You've watched The Addams Family? Really? Da 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 da. Was, oh my god, can I remember the lyrics? They're creepy and they're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together ooky, the Addams Family. Their house is a museum, and people come to see them. They really are a scream, the Addams Family. Do-do-do-do, neat, do-do-do-do, sweet, do-do-do-do, do-do-do-do, petite. So gather with your shawl on, a roof that you can crawl on. So we're gonna pay a call on the Addams Family. Oh my god, I am giving myself so much credit for remembering that. I'm impressed. Yes, I cannot believe I remember. I don't know where my cell phone is half the time. I don't know where my keys are. But I can remember the original Addams Family. I watched the Addams Family a lot. Also watched the newer Wednesday series a lot too. I was told that that was actually very good. But yes, the old Addams Family. That was such a cool show. They were always trying to, the kids were always trying to blow up one another and, you know, Lurch the butler, which there was a scene where Lurch and Wednesday danced together, and Thing, the crawling hand. Let's see, there was, and see, there was the Munsters, and then there was the Addams Family. So you had like two separate creepy families. I want to watch the new Wednesday series, but I'm afraid that I won't like it for some reason. Maybe I can watch it today. I mean, maybe, you know, you check it out. If you find it doesn't resonate with you, then let it go. Disregard it. You know, don't know if my last message sent the one about the Addams Family. I just wanted to say thank you so much for yesterday, Doc. Made me feel less alone. Oh. My pleasure, my dear. Oh, Cosmic Shade, my lovely little Nebula. Hey, Doc, only flying through tonight. I need to get to bed. Wanted to thank you for yesterday. Oh, yes. My pleasure, my dear. My absolute pleasure. And you deserve all the support and love, and I'm so proud of you for setting boundaries. You know, that's an important thing, especially with those we love. And I think they're more needed with those we love and those who we, you know, want it, who need to, us to take care of them. I think boundaries are more necessary there than in any other case. But, you know, do it! It was amazing! I watched it over and over again. It's like, do it! Do it! Do it! See, we have a personal recommendation from our wonderful, lovely little Nebula, Cosmic Shade. Man, I've been calling you a lovely little Nebula for almost 3 years now? I feel really guilty for doing it still, but I need to do it for my sanity. Exactly. And the thing is that little bit of guilt feeling, that's just the empath in you. That empathic part of you that feels that it has to be in service or else it can't feel okay. You know, that part that just like, oh no, you know, if we're not doing things for others, then, you know, we're empty. So, and that's kind of that part of us that is the empath, that wants to resonate, that wants to connect. And you are doing an amazing job of telling that part of yourself, okay, it needs to go sit down, have a Snickers, and play a video game, and that you stay in choice. You're choosing, you're not reacting, and choice is a beautiful place to be. I will totally watch it, exactly, and then come back with a review. We need a review on that, so you watch it, and I would like to get a review from you on it. You know, and it really is, Cosmic, what you're choosing is the more difficult path, but it's the one that's going to serve you. Because, you know, by taking care of yourself, it allows you to be able to go back into the situation when you need to and be able to be okay and not feel overwhelmed. You know, that's why, you know, one of the sayings that I started using, and it's probably one of the sayings that irritated people and quite honestly pissed people off when I told them, because they were so used to me always taking care of them and always being there and always, you know, where they would call me in the middle of the night, I'd wake up out of a dead sleep to listen to somebody. And a woman was like, you know, well, you need to be there for me. You need to do this. You need to take care of me. And I took a breath and I looked at her, and from somewhere deep inside of me came the words, I am happy to be a part of the solution, but I cannot and I will not be the only solution. And she got hot mad at me. But after that came out, and as I was listening to myself say it, I am happy to be a part of the solution, but I cannot and will not, choice coming in, be the only solution. Because nobody can be the only solution. No, there's no way you can do that. It's not sustainable, and you shouldn't have to. And anybody who has ever done something for somebody else, maybe it's your work, maybe it's your family, maybe it's your relationship, maybe it's whatever, be happy to be a part of the solution, but you cannot and should not be the only solution, because that also takes away from that person, because that means they're not growing, they're not learning to stand on their own 2 feet. You know, it goes back to that whole give a fish, teach to fish. In all fairness, I'm swapping one thing for another. I had to put decorating my mom's kitchen on hold while I dealt with this stuff. I want to get it done before Christmas. Well, I think that's cool. Oh, my family members got cross with me for wanting my own life back. I mean, it's like, yeah, how dare me want my own life while y'all are all out there living your own. Cosmic Shade, pinching the cheeks. So proud of you. Pinching. God, I may incorporate that. I don't know why I'm doing that in this stream. I mean, maybe it's the old woman in me. We go, oh my gosh, so good. And I used to hate that when I was little. See, growing up in the 60s meant any adult around could grab you by the face and was like, oh my God, you're so cute. Fist bump high five for anybody who has ever had an old person grab them by the face. It's like, Mom, it hurts. Oh, be quiet. Just let them do it. You know, sometimes people ask you for the moon, but not realizing you are your own person too, with your own needs and wants. Exactly. Been there, done that. Bought the t-shirt and the matching sweats, I would assume. You know, I just have the feeling you've got the whole ensemble, you know, with matching sneakers. And, you know, I mean, and it is. It's not sustainable. And, you know, sometimes you give, and for some people, it's like, oh, thank you. Thank you for the boost. I can handle it from here. And the other ones are like, oh, so now you're going to become my emotional ATM, where if I'm upset day or night, whatever, you will make me your priority. And it's not fair, because we have to make us our priority. When you have so little presence, sliding doors don't open for you. Oh, let's see, wait. Last 3 months, I understand I needed to be here. Exactly. But now things are getting back to some sort of normalcy. They need to learn to cope on their own. That is empowering. That helps other people to grow. You know, it is, and like I said, you know, the old saying, when one door closes, another opens, try opening the door again. It's a door. That's what they do. And, you know, and Loki, you know, I know that you will, the only sliding glass door you are going to face that is not open will be the one facing out on a beautiful winter night that is absolutely chilly, so you can see the beauty of the falling snow while at the same time being nice, warm, and cozy inside. I got dark chocolate almonds, woo! Oh my gosh, dark chocolate almonds, I love dark chocolate almonds. Oh, Loki. Oh, I would eat dark chocolate almonds and Ovaltine. Fist bump, high five if anybody has ever had Ovaltine. Ovaltine was the best. It was from my childhood. I need to get myself some more Ovaltine. That and strawberry quick. I'm 30 and my body feels like I'm 80 now. Everything hurts all the time. Had to buy a knee brace because apparently WD-40 doesn't stop it creaking and it hurts. Oh, sweetheart. Well, I think I am even more proud of you for the choice you've made, because that is going to be, I mean, and yes, you're, you know, going to go and help your mom, but that goes into something that you get to do, not something you have to do. And I am so proud of you for prioritizing yourself and what you want to do. Y'all, you know, it's Think About It Thursday. I'd like you to think about, or I could offer to you, why not think about something that makes you happy, that serves no other purpose than making you happy? You know, people say it's like, well, I want to do things that better the world. Well, guess what? Making you happy betters the world. So it accomplishes. My teacher bullied me out of school for being too skinny, so you could say the doors didn't open for me because of my little presence. I was just about to turn my life around. You know what? Pa-pa-pa-bang. You know, first off, that was not okay. You did not deserve that. And you are you, and you are on your journey and on your path, and however you want to walk that. And I know that your life is going to go into some amazing directions, and turning around is just going to be spinning happily. Have you ever, when you were a kid, did any of you ever like just spin around until you got dizzy and fell down, and that was fun? What, just me? Anyway, but no, there's going to be a lot of turnarounds in your life, and they're going to be amazing, and each one is going to be like a rotation of the earth, and that's going to be a very cool thing for you. My back cracks every time I move. Warehouse work is painful. Warehouse work is intense. Door, huh? Good God, y'all. What is this for? Absolutely nothing. Door. Good God, y'all, what is it good for? Absolutely nothing. Say it again. Aiden, okay, fist bump high five for bringing up something from my old days. Oh my God, because for a second it was like, I almost didn't get, okay. That goes into a special wing of the Punder Dome. That needs to go to the Punder Dome. Please put it there. But it is going into a special wing with a special dungeon that goes down to the absolute core of the earth, where it will sit in the magma thinking about what it's done. That goes to a whole deeper level of the Punder Dome. Hey, Doc, howdy. How the fox are y'all doing? I love that. It was an adult school, too. I was the youngest one in the class, so there was also one more excuse for him to bully me daily. Oh, that sucks. Guess what me and the little munchkin did? Oh, what did you and the little munchkin do? Yeah, I used to spin around like that and run into a lake. Okay, I used to spin. I can quite honestly say that I have never spun and run into a lake. And yet now I feel like I need that in my life. My life will not be, I need to add that to my bucket list, to spin around on the shore of a lake and then run into the lake. I need to make that happen. I mean, I have the paint for the kitchen for over... You've had the paint for over 6 years. Finally got around to emptying the kitchen, ready to decorate, and then the family emergency came up. It has just sat there, so kind of need to now. Oh, just doing my job. Salute. We made you... You made me a new song. Oh, my goodness, that's so sweet of you. Just make sure it's not off a dock to the deep end. Off a dock? I crack me up. My daughter helped me with the setup. This is awesome, Doc. Tabby even sat still like a good little one and worked hard on it for you. Oh, Tabby, that is so sweet of you. Puns. Oh, my goodness. But, oh, Big Bad Fox, that is, you tell I sent it to you. Hold on. Hold the phone. We need, is it in, whispers? Hold on. We need to find a thing. Talk amongst yourselves for a second. Let me look. Let's see. Watch over me, reasons undisclosed. Okay, so this is an original piece. Our wonderful, for those of you who don't know, our wonderful Big Bad Fox 19 is an amazing, amazing musical compiler and creates this beautiful music and has done stuff for me, which I am so tremendously honored and, you know, and our beautiful, beautiful, you know, little Tabby who's been involved in this. Okay, so we're gonna finish up the stream by checking this out. I love how it layers, how it builds up. And Fox created these for me. I mean, it's like...
Tone supposed to creep and crawl inside my soul, reason undisclosed. As if every tone supposed to creep and crawl inside my soul, reason undisclosed.
I mean, we're talking professional level stuff here.
As if every tone's supposed to creep and crawl inside my soul, reason undisclosed.
And got gangs on a roll.
As if every tone's supposed to creep and crawl inside my soul, reason undisclosed. As if every tone's supposed to creep and crawl inside my soul, reason undisclosed.
Wow. Absolutely. This is your Halloween-y one. Wow. I mean, I am so honored. The thing I love so much about your music and what you create is that it's almost like all of these layers
that kind of, it's like they fold in and peel back at the same time, you know, and it does, it's almost like it goes through this big cycle and reaches a place of completion where it's almost like it's back where it started, but not, you know, and it is, you know, and Tabby, tell Tabby that thank you, mwah, thank you, sweetie, so much. It is so unique and all made just for those I care about. Oh, I'm gonna get me all emotional. I have to drink some tea. That is so sweet of you. That is so amazing. Thank you so much. You know, I just love it. I just absolutely love it. Thank you. And on that musical note, you know, and if Doc ever does a giveaway promotion, I may even do one for her top donators. We're going to have to think about that on our subathon days. Thanks for the stream. I wasn't harassed so much. Catch you on the flip side, y'all. Catch you on the flip side. See you in the comic or see you in the funny papers. And, you know, I wish I wasn't. I wish you wasn't either. And you deserve to be treated well and beautifully and amazingly because you're so amazing. And thank you, Big Vad Fox. Thank you, everybody who came into the stream. And we will see you tomorrow. And we'll be focusing on what we focus on for Focus Friday. I have to head off to bed. Thank you, Doc, for everything. Sorry I've been a bit off, everyone. No! Cosmic, you're doing amazing, and we're so proud of you. Just going through some stuff. Good night, all. Much love. Next time, I'll get gold again. Yes, adios. Cosmic Jade, Tabby says she's happy. You and Auntie Doc liked it. We loved it. And Aiden, bye. And everybody, you know, thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting the stream on the Kickverse, in the Twitchverse. You know, we're building something, and I'm so happy and so grateful and so honored that you guys are here with me on this journey. And, you know, we're going to go somewhere. Lieutenant Dan's legs! Hey, Doc, guess what? What? I guess I am late. Yes, you are, my dear, but that's okay. Better late than never. It's just brilliant. Tell Tabby she did a great job. She did. She was such a sweetheart. So, we brought a duck for the ranch. Tabby, name it. Ducky, Ducky. Okay, now I'm definitely coming to visit you guys. We have to set up a time for me to come visit because I've got to meet Dr. Ducky. So, everyone, football playoff games tomorrow. Yes! Okay, for those of you who don't know, Lieutenant Dan's Legs is an amazing referee. It takes a lot to be a referee, and who does it awesome with grace and teaches young people good sportsmanship and all kinds of stuff and stands in his authority, which is amazing. Dear friend. Anyway, and he rides a motorcycle. So we will see you tomorrow, same bat time, same bat station, 5 o'clock p.m. Eastern time. And I hope everyone has just an amazing time, whatever the time of day is for you, that you get your rest, that you take care of yourself. Please remember that your life will follow your thoughts. So be careful about where your thoughts are taking you. Please, please have a great evening. You too, my dear, and enjoy those games. Please, please remember that you don't have to think the thoughts other people want you to think if they don't resonate with you. You've got your own thoughts to think, and that's a cool thing. And please, 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 please remember. Hold on, let me get, I had to click on a couple of things. Please remember that you are the only you in all the universe. You're the only you that's ever been and the only you that will ever be. And what that does is it makes you special. It makes you sacred, and most of all, it makes you necessary because, as the only you in all of the universe would not be the same or complete without you. She says, Daddy has lots of fun toys. Hey, Doc, Tabby says she has fun playing with Daddy's music thingies. Oh, so when I come to visit Tabby, I can see all, you can show me all Daddy's music thingies. So everyone, please have an amazing morning, afternoon, evening, or night. And as always, I wish you balance and I wish you blessings from my heart to yours. Told her they're not toys. Hey, anything amusing is a toy. So everyone, have a good day. Learn something new. I'm proud of you. And I love you. All right, folks, we are going to head out. The train, the love train, is pulling out of the station. It will be back again tomorrow. Take care, everyone. The cheapest thing I have in my set is up $800. Well, then that's a daddy toy. Anyway, we will see you tomorrow. Bye. And woo-woo!